Sylvia's life in a nutshell. As you can see, she started off old and got older. Sylvia, you are a legend. You are a goddess. We worship you. You know, we only say nice things about you backstage.
Do I come up now?
Contour extraordinaire, please, Racont.
Shut the music off.
Let the Racont
begin. Shut it off. Shut it off. I want to thank a few people. My God, I got more people at Jocks on a Saturday night than I have here tonight. Leave that trophy there, Mary. Let me see this trophy. You wouldn't believe this trophy. They raised about $50,000. They couldn't even inscribe my name on this plaque. Would you believe that? This is the first trophy I've ever got in my entire life. In fact, I got a trophy 2 months ago, a Lifetime Achievement Award from the In magazine. A beautiful plaque. I have it at home in my bathroom.
Well, Sylvia, you know,
when
people receive the Academy Awards, the engraving is done after they receive.
Oh, the engraving done afterwards?
Yes, afterwards.
Is that when they're going to give me the envelope and take it off the stage?
Vast amounts of cash.
Lovely, lovely.
Thank you, Sylvia.
Wait a second. I'm not done.
I tried. Please say a few words, Sylvia.
What did they arrest you for?
Oh, what did they arrest me for? The first time was a grand larceny. The second time was pornography. Yes, pornography, yes. That was in 19... What year was that? I'll tell you what year I went to jail. 1957 was pornography. Possession of pornography.
Oh.
Yeah, possession of pornography. And I had to talk to the... I believe it was the district attorney. And he was looking at these pictures. He says, how could you have taken... posed for these pictures and, you know, a young man like yourself... I thought, if you don't like them, what do you get your legs crossed for? And he stood up mad with a fabulous erection in his pants. I says, my, they must have excited you. He says, out of my office. I says, I'll leave soon, dear. And I trolloped out of that room there. Yes. It was quite gay. I did 6 months in the House of Correction for that little bit. Because they got me that night in full. I was on probation, and I was ready to leave. Halloween. It was Halloween 1957. Was it 56? 57. Halloween 57. I was dressed like a negress. I used shoe polish to cover my face, and you know, and I had a neon green here, which I sprayed. I did it white, and I sprayed it with a luminous paint. And I had a 18-foot fur stole made out of two old fur coats, and I lined it with blue satin, and the rest of the fabric I made a split skirt. I had a neon green top against the brown skin, looked very effective, and they arrested me at the Terrain Cafe, and they gave me a hard time going over with the paddy wagon to the station. I had to appear in court the next morning, and they found I was on probation. I was ready to leave the next day for Florida. And they gave me 6 months in the Deer Island House of Correction, Winthrop, went by the sea. They called it Winthrop by the Sea. I would have had a fabulous time there in jail. Fabulous time.
She represents freedom of expression.
And they knew I was gay, of course. And I used to have a lookout for me. A little black queen who's gone now, passed on, Jerry Allen. When the screw was a screw, that's what they call a guard in jail. I was up there on the deck, the second or third deck, talking to the prisoners who were in confinement, who were fighting and whatnot. They lock them up for 3 days. They give them, supposed to give them bread and water. That was years ago. Now they give them one meal a day. And I would proposition these guys. I would say, honey, if you stick it through the bars, let mother have a little. You know, I'll feed you well. And some of them would say, you fucking fag, get away from me, you queer bastard. You know, and all that jazz. I said, all right, honey. We'll see who's a queer bastard. And the screw would, if the screw would start coming over, the queen would start tap dancing, you know, on the steel floor. So I better, hey, Sylvia, what are you doing up there? You know? You're taking too long washing the floors up there. I said, I'm doing a very good job, Joe, you know. And I would scurry downstairs and the food, I would dish out the food. Now, the prisoners in solitary confinement that put out for Sylvia Sidney, they got three pieces of, they were only allowed one piece of bread. I would put three pieces of bread on the steel plate and cover it with a thick soup or beef stew or lamb stew, whatever, you know, and give them a couple of slices besides, you know, and have the little colored green bring them up to the prisoners, you know. And, well, the guy was up there with the keys anyway. And some afterwards, the 3 days, some guys came out and says, hey, fag, this fag didn't feed me. She fed every... And so the screw, the guy says, well, you should have taken care of her, mother. Fabulous. The screw knew what was going on. You know, never said nothing. I was in that place for 6 months. You know, it was carry on wild. It was wild.
Steven and our bartenders and waiter, thank you, good night, and drive safe.